I have created the Wi-Fi cup. It has a little ESP8266 on top, hooked up to some WS2812s, and a battery. And somebody wanted to know how long it takes to link. So what I'm going to do is unplug it, start trying to ping it. I'm going to plug it in. 1001, one, oh, there we go. I'd say it woke up and linked in under a second there. So that's pretty cool. What I actually have going on here is a cup that when it receives UDP packets, or rather it sends them and when it receives responses, it gets brighter. If I kill a task that goes and responds to them, makes them, you know, come back, it gets dimmer. So if I start the task, bright, dim, bright, dim. So if I do something that would make it so that I can't talk to the network, I touch it just right, I can actually make the antenna stop working, and that causes it to get dim. So I'm going to use this to tell where in my house I can get Wi-Fi with this little ESP8266. Because I live with ridiculous roommates, they have some ridiculous networking equipment, and my roommate, to make this test a little bit more fair, dropped the transmit power to 4 dBm. So this is going to be a little bit more fair for like a normal home router that's not ridiculous. So here's the cup, there's the little Wi-Fi access point thing, and I'm just going to go kind of walk around here, downstairs, over here to this corner. Let's go put this up here. Still just fine. Let's go over here. What about this corner? Yep, still have internet. Try the garage. Still have internet. Let's make sure it's still working. Oh, yep. If I kill the antenna, it's dead, but I don't know. This is working just about everywhere here. Let's put it over here next to the... Good grief, even next to the breaker box, it's still just dandy. This thing does not want to die. I don't think there's anywhere inside that I can go that would make it disconnect. Okay, now outside my house. Hello, house. Hello, internet light. I'm gonna walk away from my house. Oh, packets are starting to get dropped a little. Kind of see it flickering some. Not very many, though. Let's see, let's go into the street. Oh, it's starting to phase out. Okay, keep on going, keep it on. It's certainly spotty. There's some areas where I can get data and some I can't. It's interesting. Although this is kind of ridiculous now. Okay, this is a terrible test. Well, because Will's wireless access point is too ridiculous, I'm using this TP-Link, and I'm nerfing the antennas and putting on these tiny little terrible ones. I guess this is a little bit more like what most people have. And I did notice that when I do this, the amount of time that it takes for it to turn on is a little bit longer. So I can see now I'm plugging it in now, and it's linking now. So that took a little bit extra time with this router. It's kind of surprising that the hardware matters, but apparently really good hardware links faster. And you can see it's still working, and we're going to see how this goes now. Okay. I have the access point at a corner of my house there. And I'm going to be walking through the house here, see if it drops out anywhere. Door, cubby hole. Let's see, I don't know, where would you put an internet light? Okay, it's all still working here. Let's try my room. Floor, corner, nope, still working. And garage. Surely this will fail. No, it still has not failed. Seriously? Let's try to... Yeah, it's definitely working if I touch it. Grief. Fine. We'll have to figure something else out. Oh, hey! I put it in this bucket with metal. Oh, no, it's... put my hand here, it will stop working. Okay.